he made these two systems of medicine institutionalized. So proper syllabus was framed, curriculum was developed, institution was developed, and in the year 1916, the A and U Tibya College, Ayurvedic and Unani Tibya College, came into the existence in Delhi, and this is the unique college of the entire world in which the Ayurvedic and Unani system of medicine, the two different systems of medicine, are being taught under the same roof under one administrative control. He is the man who borrowed the subject, basic subjects of the science from the allopath and included in our system, traditional system of medicine, anatomy, physiology, pharmacology, you know, pathology, surgery, jurisprudence, hygiene, gynae, ops, research methodology even, all these subjects were included, a syllabus, a comprehensive syllabus was developed and which is still being taught in all the institutions of the India. I'm very happy to inform you, first time when I joined the ministry in 2013, I was assigned the duty to develop the concept note for establishment of National Institute of Swarikpa. And I did this work, and same vision I had put in it. When I developed the curriculum for this, when I developed the different department for this institute, I included anatomy, physiology, research methodology, biochemistry, bacteriology, everything was ahead I put, so that our student who is passing from the graduation course must be in position to conduct the research, and the research on that parameters which is accepted to the entire community, scientific community at international level. So this man is a historical man who has developed all these things, and the vision which he had given around so many years back, still it is continuing, 100 years back, still it is continuing. Then another Hakim Abdul Hamid Sahab is another important physician of the Indian subcontinent. He developed Hamdard Dawakhana. You must be knowing the Hamdard Dawakhana, very famous for Sinkara, very famous for Ru Abza, and very famous for various Unani drugs. He had developed a university in Delhi. This university is meant for professional courses, having the faculty of Unani medicine, modern medicine, allopathic medicine, nursing, science, pharmacy, and so many professional courses. Then Hakim Abdul Hamid was there. This man had founded the Center Council for Research in Unani Medicine. He is the founder director for Center Council for Research in Unani Medicine, and he continued to be the director for about 17 years. Whatever the development in the field of the research is being seen in this country or outside the country, this is the vision of Hakim Abdul Razak Sahab. Education, of course, we have a robust infrastructure for education, and education is being regulated by an act of parliament known as Indian Medicine Central Council Act 1970. Under this act, CCIM, Central Council of Indian Medicine, has come into the existence, and the mandate of this council is to regulate the practice and education of Ayurveda, Unani, Siddha system medicine, and now even the Swarikpa has been included in it. As far as education, teaching institutions are concerned, for Unani system medicine, around 55 teaching institutions across the country are available, and out of which, and the intake capacity is around 3,000 per year. 3,000 students per year are getting admitted and passing out, and around 55 colleges are there. And out of which, 14 colleges are offering PG education. Out of 55, 14 are postgraduate institution, and around 200 students are passing out every year. And as far as the PhD education is concerned, three institutions are imparting PhD education. One is at Delhi, that is Jamia Millia Islamia University, and second is at the National Institute of Unani Medicine in Hyderabad, Bangalore, and third one is in Hyderabad. These are the various subjects in which Unani Medicine is offering the postgraduate education. 10 disciplines, 10 subjects, post-graduation education is being imparted. These are the names of the colleges, around 14 colleges, which are imparting post-graduate education in Unani Medicine. And in every part of the country, the post-graduate college for Unani Medicines are available. These are the names of those. And out of which one institution belongs to Government of India, that is National Institute of Unani Medicine, Bangalore. It's a quite huge institution, spread over 100 acres of the land, offering education for post-graduation and PhD only. And of course, it's a very good center for the treatment of the paralysis, post-stroke patient. These are the name of the PhD institutions, which I have already discussed. As far as practice is concerned, over 52,000 doctors, registered medical practitioners of Unani Medicine, having qualified degree, having degree from the educational institutions, are available across the country, 52,000. 264 hospitals are there, and around 1,500 dispensaries are available in the country, and 600 GMP certified drug manufacturing units are available of Unani Medicine in the country. Then Government of India has a Pharmacopoeia Commission for Indian System of Medicine, and not only the Indian medicine, but rather Indian medicine and homeopathy. And inshallah, very shortly, the Sova Rigpa will also be included in it. Pharmacopoeia Commission, under the Pharmacopoeia Commission, we have four Pharmacopoeia Committee, Unani Pharmacopoeia Committee, Ayurvedic Pharmacopoeia Committee, Siddha Pharmacopoeia Committee, Homeopathic Pharmacopoeia Committee. And the purpose of this commission is to develop the standards for our herbs, raw material, and finished product, compound drugs also, so that the adulteration of the drug can be provided, low quality of the drugs can be stopped in the market. These are the certain objectives we have discussed. Unani Pharmacopoeia Committee, it's headed by always scientists, and there is a member from various disciplines of the science like biotechnology, pharmacology, chemistry, and botany, etc. Of course, Unani physicians also there, and their purpose is to describe the standards for various drugs. And as far work is concerned, right now, till date, around 298 single Unani herbs have been standardized and their monograph have been published. And similarly, for compound drugs, 150 compound drugs standards have been made and their monograph have already been published. Then another important component is research. Without research, nothing can happen. Rather, research is the, yesterday our learned friend was talking, Dr. Rastogi, the three important things, practice, research, and education, they go forward hand in hand. Otherwise, in isolation, nothing is possible. In isolation, nothing could, no system can flourish. You need education, you need practice, and you need research. research, whatever the research is being done, that should go to the education and research, that should be taught to the students, and the students should do the practice of the same thing. This is the cycle. So research is a very important thing of Unani system medicine, and by and large, the research is in the hands of the Central Council for Research in Unani Medicine. It is an autonomous organization under the Ministry of Ayush, Government of India. And second place where the research is being conducted is the teaching institutions, PhD and PG institutions are also conducting the research. And third is in extramural research. This is again within the ambit of the Ministry of Ayush. Ministry of Ayush is having a cell, important cell, especially dedicated for the research in extramural mode. And till 14th of this month, February, I had been looking after, I was the program officer of extramural research in the ministry. As a Central Council for Research in Unani Medicine was established sometime 1979, and it has around 23 centers across the country, out of which two are the Central Research Institute, eight are the Regional Research Institute, then some drug standardization units are there, some clinical research establishments are there, some literary research institutions are there. So these are the details about them. And what are the major outcomes of research? The four areas are there in which the CCRM is focusing for the research. The first one is medicinal plant survey and And the second one is drug standardization and quality control. And the third one is preclinical research, experimental research on animal beings. And the fourth one is clinical research. And another is literary research. Under this literature program, the literature of Unani medicine is mostly available in the Persian Arabic language. So their translation into English, into Hindi, into Urdu is being made through this research program. About 120 formulations have been tested in 13 diseases till date, and 10 patents have been granted, and 43 patents are in pipeline. We have got a number of the projects under collaborative research, in which the CCRM is conducting research with the collaboration of the various important scientific organizations like AIIMS, like ICMR, like Patel Chest, like various universities in the country. In the field of skin, we have done wonderful work. In Hyderabad, we have Central Research Institute of Unani Medicine. And in this institution, we have developed a wonderful treatment for the treatment of the vitiligo, white patches. As such, no treatment in any system of medicine is available. But Unani is having a very good treatment for vitiligo. In the last 20 years, around 20 lakhs patients we have treated over there. Under extramural research, which is being run by the ministry, around 211 projects. Okay, just a minute. 2 minutes. Under extramural research, which is being run by the ministry, 211 projects till date have been funded. 102 drugs have been validated, and 13 patents have been filed, and 208 publications have been made. Under this program, we are inviting the project from the various prestigious institutions of the research for conducting the research in Ayush system of medicine. For that matter, we are giving them financial assistance of 70 lakhs rupees for a period of 3 years. So this is a very good program. I really invite all of you to submit your project in the Ministry of Ayush for conducting the research under EMR. So these are the area of the research we have already discussed. Future development. The Government of India has planned to develop All India Institute of Unani Medicine at Ghaziabad. For this institution, 10 acres of the land in Ghaziabad, nearby Delhi, rather it is nothing but round, connected to Delhi in NCR, National Capital Region of Delhi, the 10 acres of the land has been allotted. I'm lucky enough, I was again assigned to develop the concept note and DPR, detailed project report, report for this institution. I have completed it. Money have been released. In initial phase, 302 crores of the rupees have been given for the development of this institute. And I feel very shortly, within few years, this institute will come into the existence. And the primary focus of this institution would be to impart the education at doctoral, postgraduate and doctoral level, interdisciplinary research, these and tertiary health care. Other future developmental program, CCIM has, Central Council for Research in Unani Medicine have the plan to develop various institutes in every part of the country to conduct the research in their respective areas. And the Ministry of Ayush has a plan to expand the CHS, means to create more post of the doctors, to create the more post dispensaries in Unani medicine under this research program. And the Ministry of Ayush is also planning to establish National Institute of Research in Non-Communicable Diseases for CCRM in Faridabad, nearby Delhi. Now I'm coming to the challenges. You know, a lot of challenges is there. As far as our problem is, what exactly? Our system is oriental, philosophical, but we have to prove our system on scientific lines. So what the Government of India is doing, by collaborating with the modern sciences, we are just putting the science behind the tradition so that our system is being established as scientific system at international level and being accepted by the entire scientific community at international level. So this is a big challenge, because oriental subjects are to be proven on scientific, philosophical subjects are to be proven on scientific parameters. This we are doing exactly. So the biggest challenge which I feel in the Unani medicine is batch-to-batch variation of the drugs. We are producing the drugs, but every batch is having a different, I mean, there is a variation of the standards. So having, we have set the, you know, we have almost 150 drugs have been standardized, and the standards have been set. But even then, batch-to-batch variation is there, and because of so many factors, agriculture, good agriculture factor, practice factor, you know, collection practice factor, storage factor, so many factors are there, but we are trying our best so that the batch-to-batch variation can be minimized. Then shelf life of Unani drugs in classical literature, of course it is written that the life of this drug is so much, but as such, till date, we do not have any scientific data. So that data is to develop by using the modern science. That work is going on. This is another challenge. Then redesigning of the drug, another very important, you know, in Unani medicine, most of the drugs are sugar-based, like syrup, like majun, like khamira in the form of the paste. They contain a lot of sugar, and those medicine cannot be given to the diabetic patient. When India is going to become the, you know, capital for the diabetics, every third patient is going to be diabetic, how this medicine can be given? It's just impossible. So we are thinking in redesigning of the doses form. Drug, I mean, the sugar has to be eliminated. It has to be converted into the form of the capsule, tablets, or nano forms, etc. So this is a big work, quite big challenge. Whenever you are changing the shape of the drug, as per the definition or recommendation of the WHO, it is considered a new drug, and new drug has to go through the all regulatory framework, that is preclinical, clinical, and all that. So this work is going on, redesigning of the dosage form. And third one is toxicity and safety evaluation of the drug. In our classical literature, many drugs are there, about 5,000 drugs are there. But of course, they do write that the drug is safe. But let me tell you very thing, very frankly, the drug which is having action will have the reaction. If it is not having the reaction, action, there is no reaction. So drug inert and drug cannot be inert. The thing which is having action will have the reaction. So you can say these drugs are having least toxicity is there, least side effects are there, but side effects are there, those to be, identified, and toxicity study has to be done. And scientific data in this regard has to be generated. Only yesterday I have suggested my friend Dostogi when he was speaking, that we have to develop the data in terms of the quality control of the drug. We have to develop the data. Just 2 minutes. So safety and efficacy. So safety, for safety matter, the data is to be generated. And conduction the randomized control trial. Without this clinical trial, nobody is going to accept our drug. And we are in process to conduct the randomized control trial. There a lot of education reforms are to be done in our education system. The continuous revision of the syllabus and curriculum. It's a continuous process. Science, medicine is such a dynamic subject. You cannot claim yourself to be the master of one disease for 30 days, more than 30 days. Always it keeps on changing. And similarly, this knowledge is to be transmitted to the student. So every year, every 5 years, there must be some revision of your syllabus and curriculum. And the bridge courses of Unani medicine is to be developed for other system of medicine, like Suvaripa people, allopathic people, Ayurveda people, they can come and study bridge course of 6 month duration, 1 year duration, so that this knowledge can be disseminated to other people. Okay, sir, thank you. Thank you for your patience learning. Thanks, Chair, you have granted me extra time.
Thank you. Thank you very much for your good presentation. Or iske baad question, 2 questions.
Thank you for this very interesting talk. It was mostly about the historical development and so on. My question is about the current situation and size of the industry. Can you say in a few words roughly what is the size comparatively to the Ayurvedic industry, or what is the portion of Unani within the Ayush systems? That is one question. And the other question I have is, what is the situation outside of India? Is there Unani medicine practiced, for example, in Pakistan, in Bangladesh? We've heard it's practiced by the Uyghurs in Xinjiang. Anywhere else? Can you enlighten us about that, please?
Thank you, sir, for making the question. And as far as size is concerned, I do admit Ayurveda is big brother of Unani. It is not big. It's very, very, very big brother. We are having around 600 industry, and they are having around 6,000 industries in the country. We are having 55 colleges, and they are having 250 colleges. So in every terms, the acceptability of the Ayurveda in this country is much more greater than the Unani. But of course, our presence is there, and pan-India presence is there. And a lot of acceptability is there in India, a lot of patients for Unani medicines. People are coming for Unani medicine treatment, for vitiligo, for eczema, for mental disorder. They are coming specifically for brain, organ-specific tonics. Number of diseases are there, like gout. Patients are coming for Unani treatment only. So this is the position. As far as size is concerned, size in terms of finance, in terms of budget, I'm not in position to give you this figure, because as such, there is no separate budget in the ministry which is indicated for Unani or the Ayurveda. It's a it's a, you know, it's a combined budget, and the total budget last year of Ayush Ministry was 1,600 crores. Presence of Unani medicine at international level is concerned, around 7 countries are there in which Unani medicine is being practiced. Pakistan, Sri Lanka, of course in Nepal, and Bangladesh, Iran, Iraq, Middle East countries, and of course you told me that in China, in the name of Uyghur medicine, and in South Africa also, there is a Capstan University which is imparting the course, graduation course in Unani medicine. We have created a chair of Unani medicine at Capstan University, South Africa. Our person, a man not below the status of a professor, is working over there as a chair.
Sir, welcome. Sir, I have one question that you very well mentioned about the what's the traditional medicine should introduce through the scientific way. So, as like a Sovarigpa system, after the recognition of government in India, Sovarigpa is on at the initial stage. So we need Unani system, have you ever done like this to introduce the Unani system through the scientific research way, so that people can accept globally? So because in 2010, the Sovarigpa was recognized by government India. So now I do not understand that, don't know that which way, that which direction the Sovarigpa system is leading. So I want your suggestion and what is possible.
Thank you, it's a wonderful question. And I understand your pain, what you do have in your heart for your system of medicine. Appreciable, really, wonderful. Of course, your system should progress, and it can progress only if it is appreciated at international level. Let me tell you, our system is nice, we can understand it. Then why to conduct the research? Research is conducted in order to extend the benefit to the patient and in order to make other people understand about our system in their own terms, in their own language. So how to go ahead? It's very important. Your system, I had developed the concept note. I must be having the copy of that in my computer. I can hand it over to you also. Whenever you are developing, you must have the vision for the development of your system in coming time after 10 years. Of course, initially, all of a sudden, Rome was not built in a day. It requires a lot of time. Of course, you need some time, at least 5 years, 10 years to develop your system as per your vision. But we must have your, you know, blueprint, how we will develop, roadmap has to develop. So initially, you should include all the subjects of science. Science and technology does not belong to any system. Radiology is common for me, it is common for allopath, it is common for homopath, it is common for Sovarigpa also. It is a technical development. No system can make any claim over it. And similarly, many things are there. So scientific system, all the scientific parameters, scientific subjects are to be included in your syllabus for anatomy, physiology, radiology, all these, and your own subject of the Sovarigpa. And the students must be very much thorough in both the fields and research methodology. This should be your vision initially. And when your students, after going through all these subjects, will come into the market, automatically they will develop further vision for the further development of your system.
Any question?
Great talk on Unani. My question is, can you shed some light on how pulse and urine diagnosis is done in Unani? And secondly, you said the air, the nature of air is hot and wet. How come the air is hot? Thank you.
Okay. First thing, your question is regarding the how the pulse reading is there and how the diagnosis on the basis of urine examination and the stool examination is met, right? Madam, it's a quite huge course. And 1 year duration is required for the study of this course. This subject is there in the third year of the BUMS, Bachelor of Unani Medicine and Surgery course. So in just 1 minute or 2 minutes, this is just impossible to make you understand. You see, pulse, rate, rhythm. First one is the rate, rhythm, then elasticity, then absence and delaying of the pulse. There are several parameters which are to be examined. What is physiological and how it is different? Volume of the pulse. When the volume of the pulse is increased, it means the patient is suffering from the hypertension. So many things are there which can, of course, if you study, you can get it. Similarly, color, if the color of the urine is very dark and it's froth over it is again with the yellow color, it's jaundice. And if the froth, I mean, bulbula upar jo hota hai, frothing, it is not yellow. Only the urine is yellow, it could be because of contamination of any dyeing material. It could be the use of the vitamin B complex. You take the B complex, your urine will be yellow. But the frothing would not be yellow. But in jaundice, the frothing would be yellow. This number of the points are there which indicates it. If the color of the stool is changed, it is white, it indicates there is a constriction at the level of common bile duct. So the bile is not reaching to the intestine and the color of stool is not being changed. Whiteness means it indicates the patient is suffering from the obstructive jaundice. So many clues are there, and this is 1 year duration course. Second thing, what you called, you have asked about the temperament of the air. It is hot and wet. Of course, it is hot and wet. The fire is hot and dry. Wetness can be seen. It's very difficult to make you understand without having the, you know, there's certain experimental ways are there to make you understand. In this, I mean, without this cannot be. It's a philosophical question. I'm unable to answer without the lab. Thank you.
Sir, one more.
Sure, I'm happy.
Yeah, regarding the urine diagnosis in the Unani, as I also done a comparative study in urine diagnosis of Swaripa and Ayurveda and modern. So the modern microscopic and then Mekongki and then all those tests which is done by the modern. So as far as in traditional, we do bubble color and sedimentation, all these things. So can there's any approach we can do scientific method to introduce the our traditional urine diagnosis?
Okay, I have been thinking this term for a very long period. The examination of urine in Unani or in other traditional system of medicine is only the microscopic, naked examination. It's a naked examination. It's not a microscopic or chemical examination. Getting my point? On the observation of the color, consistency, frothing, smell, taste, the diagnosis is made. But in modern science, they do not believe on this subjective parameter. They need objective parameters. They study it under the microscope. They study it with the help of the certain chemicals. So back, the chemical examination is done, microscopic examination, other examination is done. So that's a different field. But of course, some correlation can be established. For example, if color of the urine, what I have indicated earlier, the color of the urine is yellow, dark yellow, and the frothing is also yellow, then you test it, there is a presence of the bile pigment. So this is a correlation. So it's a scientific work, it can be done further also. If the color of the urine is white, it is as white as curd, consistency is as like milk, so some sort of the correlation can be made, it is present in the chyluria. So this is a further work which can be conducted. Anything else? I'm very happy really to Listen, your enthusiasm is great, really. And I wish you all the best. I wish a very successful journey of Suvarikpa right from today.
Thank you. Thank you very much, sir.
Thank you, Professor. So I now request Dr. Tinle Pasana to kindly offer a thank you scarf. Thank you.